Why would you build a hidden room out in the middle of the Mojave Desert? If you were a rancher, maybe you wanted to hide your tools. If you were a miner, maybe you were going to store dynamite or gold. If you're an outlaw, stolen loot. What if it's something darker? What if you didn't want to hide something, but somebody? As humans, it's no surprise that we like our mysteries large. The pyramids, the lost continent of Atlantis, Stonehenge. Well, today, out in the Mojave, we have something a little more mundane and down-to-earth, but equally interesting. A small room, hidden in the boulders. A room with a locking iron door. The part of the Mojave Desert that became Joshua Tree National Park has a well-deserved reputation for beauty and incredible views. Each year, millions of people enjoy its natural charm and fabulous rock formations. And one of the favorite spots for rock climbers and campers are the boulder piles behind the Hidden Valley campground. But how many visitors know of the area's history and unanswered questions? The place that now houses campers and their tents was once reportedly used by rustlers and outlaws to pen the stolen cattle and horses they had purloined from down in the low desert, the Coachella Valley of modern music festival fame. They would drive the animals up and hold them in the circular cluster of rocks, hence its name, Hidden Valley. But it's the boulders behind the campground that hold an intriguing mystery, the Iron Door Cave, or as it's known to some, the Desert Dungeon. Under the overhang of a large boulder pile, someone fashioned a small room, complete with steps and a locking iron door. A door that locks only from the outside. Inside its cramped quarters, now covered in graffiti and soot from numerous fires, the room offers little clues as to its original purpose. But the legends and theories are numerous. Some say it is merely a place where local miners stored their explosives, since it was common practice to store the volatile dynamite and nitroglycerin away from the main diggings, but usually marked in red paint and with the word explosives written large over the door. Others say it was where the local cowboys and ranchers who ran the area's mines or stamp mills kept their bullion before transporting it to town, either legally obtained gold or indeed the riches they had stolen from other miners or prospectors, either from the mills or at gunpoint. But it's the third story that is the most horrifying, and it goes like this. A local family living in the remote desert had a child, a misshapen, deformed boy who grew large into what was termed a monster. Unable to control him at home, the father had built this little dungeon out in the rocks to keep the child in, bringing him food and water as needed, but always keeping the door locked and bolted from the outside. Until one day, he came and found the lock broken, the door open, and the monster gone. Where he went and what became of him was never discovered, yet some swear he caused a reign of terror until brought down in a hail of bullets somewhere out in the vast Mojave. It's a well-stated truism that the simplest answer is often the best answer. And in this case, I don't know what that is. What is interesting is the reaction of people that have stumbled onto the cave over the years. Some who claim psychic abilities say that something bad happened there, that the place drips with a sense of dread and evil. Others use it as a great place to get high and write their names and make colorful graffiti on the walls inside. I myself can claim no psychic ability and can say only that it's interesting why someone went through the trouble to make a little cave with an iron door out in the rocks where no one would find it. Something was being hidden, or someone, I don't know.
One can only hope it was never used as a dungeon, as aside from the obvious cruelty and loneliness of such an existence, living out here in the scorching heat with only the rattlesnakes, tarantulas, and scorpions for company would be enough to drive anyone to murder. We can only pray that it was just a spot where explosives, tools, or even stolen loot was kept. At least that way, we can spare ourselves the horror of thinking what it must have been like to be a prisoner in the desert dungeon.
I'm M.L. Behrman, and this is Mojave Mysteries.